Right, this is Dave in night and industrial setting as well. Maybe you can see it, but it's very industrial. Yes, this time I'm coming back from the screening of the ninth film by Quentin Tarantino, which is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. And just believe me, it's absolutely marvelous. Just leave everything you're doing and just go and see it. It's a film purely made of love for cinema. And you have actually everything what you would desire in such a film, whether you are Tarantino's fan or just a cinephile in general. So basically, for most part, for the most part, no English, sorry, for you know, the major part of the film, it's like a love letter to the time in the cinema that once has been. And obviously it now evolved into something else. So this is expressed in like a number of ways. Primarily we see, you know, the mock series being produced, as well as you know, marketed you know, for the audiences. We participate you know, in the production process, as well as we see, you know, some finished product and, you know, a little bit of like, you know, publicity for it. Then you know, some scenes in the film actually feel like reenactment, like the party in the Playboy mansion. It totally feels like, you know, it's just like, you know, like a field game to bring that world back, you know, which, you know, I mean, you know, sometimes the idea behind the cinema, yeah, but you feel it very well. And then also in form of the form of the film also, you know, expresses exactly that love for cinema, it being a love letter, because there are some scenes in it shot in a manner that it would be done like, you know, at the end of 60s, yeah? So for example, there is a scene where, you know, Margot Robbie, you know, is driving a car, which also happens, is... Margot Robbie is driving a car and she picks up a passenger, and then they have like a little exchange, very short exchange, which is filmed from the outside of the car, from like a little distance. It's like three quarters, you know, shot, yeah, of like, you know, three quarters portrait, and you can just see, you can just hear that exchange, you know, flawlessly. It's like, you know, it's like voice over, yeah. Today you would have like a shot, like a close-up from the inside of the car, like shot reverse shot, you know, within the conversation. And here, you know, all of that conversation was recorded from the outside, and you could still like, you know, hear it like, you know, flawlessly. And then when that car you know, drives away, camera zooms out a little bit, so it feels like the car drives away into the world. And when you see it, you just like feel it like. Like as if it was something filmed, you know, exactly at that time. I would say, like, you know, probably mostly, like, you know, I remember it from films like from 70s. I can't give like an example, but it's like, you know, general like tension. I see something like that, and I would think, oh, like that's something like from, you know, 70s, yeah, which was, you know, close, you know, in the time frame of the narrative of Once Upon the time in Hollywood. So for the major part of the film, it's something like that. It's a love letter to the cinema. It's like strongly nostalgia driven, you know, masterpiece, just a tribute to the wonder of the cinema, which, you know, as we all know, Tarantino is like one of the ultra geeks, you know, the master geeks out there, yeah. But then obviously, you know, everybody knows that film features characters of Roman Polanski and Sharon Tate, and, you know, sadly, you know, Sharon Tate has been killed by, you know, Manson cult. And the movie builds up to that. You can just like feel the tension. You just like feel terror, and then what happens? Just like nothing can prepare you for what comes next. It's just outstanding. I can't even say like anything, but believe me, I'm not a psycho. What happens in that film is just, that's probably like the craziest Tarantino film there ever has been like up to date. You just don't expect that. Nobody expected that. And believe me, like, you know, the world is beautiful. Yeah, it's just, yeah, I know, Sharon Tate and everything. But remember, like, you know, it's Tarantino, yeah? So it's something unexpected, you know. I'm not a psycho. No spoilers though, right? Just leave everything you're doing and just go and watch this film. It's like 10 out of 10. And Cliff Booth is like my new favorite character from Tarantino films. Just given that I, you know, like, you know, Brad Pitt anyway, yeah? Like, since the day, you know, I saw him in, from the day, you know, I saw him in 12 Monkeys, where he played like crazy, yeah? You know what I mean? No, I'm really pumped up. I really had an amazing time, and I enjoyed the film thoroughly, and I feel great. I just feel great after watching it. So, well, everybody, have a good night or good day. Once again, like, whenever you will watch it. And just do yourself a favor and watch Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Alright, cheers, guys.